Hello from the Bureau of Meteorology. Here's a quick weather update about ex-tropical cyclone Lincoln as it moves southwards through Western Australia today, which is Sunday, the 25th of February. So the ex-tropical cyclone did move onshore yesterday evening, Saturday night, just near Carnarvon, and it's currently placed just to the south of Carnarvon with this broad band of moisture and rain stretching further southwards. A few stats as it crossed: the heaviest rainfall was in Carnarvon, 78 millimetres there since 9 a.m. on Saturday morning. The strongest wind was a 76 kilometre an hour gust here at Geraldton, and a number of other weather stations picking up wind gusts between 60 and 65 kilometres an hour. It is possible there were stronger wind gusts that weren't registered on any gauges. None of those winds exceed the damaging wind threshold, but still strong enough to potentially have caused some minor damage across northwestern WA. Let's check out how things are set to move through Sunday and into Monday with the slow southwards movement of this low pressure area. There will be a solid dose of rain on Sunday, but what we'll see as we move into Sunday night, and in particular Monday morning, is everything weakens away really rapidly, particularly on Monday. Hardly any wet weather left, just a little bit of showery moisture down here in the far south by Monday. So really, when we're looking at rainfall, we're looking at Sunday for the majority of the wet weather associated with the system. Here's a look at how much wet weather we might see in the next 24 hours, which brings us through to 9 a.m. Australian Western Standard Time Monday morning. And where we see the yellow and orange areas, that's double digit rainfall totals, 10 to 25 millimetres for many. We could see a little bit more than that, 30 to 50 millimetres through some of these areas here, particularly around parts of the wheat belt. This could be welcome rainfall after what has been a very hot and very dry summer so far. Otherwise, we're not expecting much rain across Western Australia. Perth, just on the periphery, might see a couple of millimetres, but no significant wet weather in the state's capital. Finally, a quick look at temperatures. If you are under this wet, cloudy band here, it is going to be noticeably cooler, with temperatures in some cases in the low 20s. Of course, central and northern parts of WA continuing to drive the heat, with low to mid 40 degree temperatures across much of the state's interior. That is all for this weather update, but you can find the latest forecasts and any severe weather information at the Bureau website and on the app. Thanks very much for watching.